These two men, they love to feel and they love to inflict pain. And right off rip, both gunning right for each other. And we got to remember earlier as we witnessed that cheap shot from Dijak. And look what Dijak's targeting, the face, the nose, the forehead of Dragunov.
Look, we know that 48 hours removed from Vengeance Day, Dijak is not 100%. Ilja Dragunov is beat up, but what do we know about Ilja Dragunov? If there is an opportunity for a fight, he will welcome it with open arms.
I mean, hell, Byron, they're both beat up. I mean, how in the world are these two even competing tonight after what happened at Vengeance Day?
I'm as shocked as you are.
These two, of course, renewing a brutal, bitter rivalry from last summer, a last man standing match at Battleground. Dijak asked his wife and daughter to leave ringside before that matchup.
It was absolutely barbaric, Vic. And now these two men, with their emotions where they are, have a chance to do this again tonight.
Speaking of Battleground, it returns Memorial Day weekend, Sunday, May 26th, Savannah, Georgia. Tickets on sale now, Ticketmaster.com. But there you see Dragunov feeling the pain. Dijak is dishing it out. And Dijak talked earlier about scars. Dragunov has them. They're on his body, they're in his soul. It's what has molded him into the champion that he is on this brand.
Now, if you die, Jack, if you take another look right towards the nose. Very smart strategy, a little dirty, but effective from Dijak.
Gotta wonder if Dijak's had all night to think about.
Two, let him out.
How's that feel?
Three, Dijak.
What would he do right on the bridge of the nose of Dragunov, who is Dragunov, who promised Dijak would suffer like never before, but it's been the total opposite in these opening moments of the match.
Dijak was at Vengeance Day. He went through a battle against Joe Gacy, but he saw the battle that Ilja Dragunov had with Trick Williams. And right now, I think Dijak looks at Dragunov as a wounded animal, as a little bit vulnerable. And how many times can we actually say that about the NXT champion?
Very few and far between, but it's also Dragunov who has shown time and time again that power doesn't panic. As he looks down now on Dijak, looking for that big boom knee right to the sternum. But again, still feeling the effects is the NXT champion. Gotta imagine, is that nose broken at this point? The eyes starting to water, so to speak? Is the vision being blurred of the champion? If it is, that's a weakness. It will be exploited by Dijak.
All right, now Dragunov continuing to display the tendency that we know. The longer the match goes, the more physical the match gets, the better Dragunov gets.
Great point that you bring up. This is going to be a physical, hard-hitting affair. Take another look, feel the impact from Dragunov to Dijak. Is one more time, Dijak looking up and is seeing Dragunov, and wisely, almost out of desperation, able to save himself for a moment and deliver a kick right under the jaw. Nasty, gnarling landing from the NXT champion.
And I gotta give credit to Dijak. He's coming out here with house money. Big win at Vengeance Day. Doesn't want to leave his fate into the hands of management. That's why he came out here and confronted Ilja Dragunov.
Dijak is barking at Dragunov. He was duct taped. He was launched through a table, but he survived it. Dijak in a no disqualification match against Gacy on Sunday, as Dragunov right back in, and Dijak able to. Dijak might be a little paranoid right now.
I don't know
what he's necessarily looking for as he gets right back into the ring, and he's coming right after Dragunov, but he's a little hesitant. He's a little distracted for the moment. That just opened the door for that right hand, but not even phased, was Dijak, who just dropped the champion.
And the vulnerability exposed for Dragunov.
Been feeling the fallout of Vengeance Day all night long here on NXT, which has led us to this main event. The NXT champion, Ilja Dragunov, taking on Dijak. A rivalry renewed. These two had quite a showing for themselves this past Sunday. And big headbutt there by the NXT champion. But look, you actually brought up a great point. Earlier tonight, Dijak certainly created an opportunity for himself in this matchup.
It has been years since Dijak has had an NXT championship opportunity. so that it gets to the point, Vic, in your career where you're tired of waiting. You are ready to start taking. And this is Dijak taking that opportunity.
Oh, he's looking for feast your eyes. He was countered by the champion. Champion trying to slug back, but it's Dijak who's still standing. Right back in with a super kick under the jaw. Dragunov answering back with a pump kick. Here comes Dijak, discus, boot! And bouncing off the ropes was Dragunov. Look who's standing tall, because Dijak earlier tonight knew exactly what buttons to push. He weaponized Dragunov's own emotions to grant himself this opportunity. And I don't know how Dragunov is being able to continue to push through, but he loves pain, he loves perseverance. This one has made him the NXT champion, and can he pull it out one more time against Dijak?
Dragunov just built different. Can he hoist up Dijak? Yes, he does. At this juncture of the match.
Oh, to that nose, to the bridge of the nose from that sucker punch earlier. Dragunov, not to be denied.
Still having the wherewithal to dunk Dijak just shows you how much resilience Ilja Dragunov has.
Dijak was hoping to earn the attention of the champion. He certainly has gotten the attention of the champion here tonight. And these two, they are cut from different cloths. Two superstars who are a different breed as Dragunov perched high. Dijak not moving. Dragunov sent out from the top. I can't believe Dijak again after everything that happened this past Sunday, everything that has been happening moments ago, but boom, what a boot earlier in the match. Rock Dragunov, but he still had the presence of mind, the passion, the drive, and the fuel to put away Dijak, but Dijak somehow able to kick out.
I mentioned the incredible resilience from the NXT champion, Ilja Dragunov. I gotta give Dijak his flowers as well for hanging on, for dealing with the offensive onslaught that he is now receiving from Ilja Dragunov.
Well, Dijak also knows if somehow he can become victorious, he can use this as leverage with our general manager, Ava, for possibly a future championship matchup as Dragunov charging right in and giving Dijak a taste of his own medicine.
It looks like that opportunity to claim victory over Ilja Dragunov is starting to fade away, slowly but surely, for Dijak.
Both these superstars just trying to pull themselves up, and Dragunov now seems to have gotten his second, maybe his third, fourth win.
That's what I told you earlier, Vic. The longer the match, the harder Dragunov hits.
On Dijak, too, the same. Can be said, knee right to the nose.
Oh, wait a minute. This could be it, Vic.
Can justice be served tonight in another kick out by Dragunov? NXT Universe at a fever pitch. This, our main event. Ilja Dragunov, the NXT champion, taking on Dijak.
A match we did not expect to even see here tonight. 48 hours removed from two brutal matches in their own right. And here we are tonight. Ilja Dragunov and Dijak have gone to war again.
How's your broken nose, huh? You like that?
And again, right to the bridge of the nose in the face. He loves pain, goes Dragunov. And Dijak is trying to dish it out. Look at the grip from Dijak.
That's a Dragunov. He's gonna love this.
Series of headbutts, getting a little separation. Ooh. The chest is welting. Now is the back of Dijak.
Nothing is off limits for Dragunov right now.
Looking for Constantine. Special guy caught. Dijak dropping the NXT champion. What is it going to take to keep the other down? And the scary thing is, Byron, both these men are willing to destroy themselves to destroy the other. And Dijak springboarding into action with that elbow. But let's not forget the elbow that was damaged this past Sunday at Vengeance Day in the no disqualification match.
And just that moment of favoring the injured elbow opened up an opportunity for Dragunov.
On social media, I don't know if you noticed, but Dijak posted a photo of that elbow. It was swollen, looked like a tennis ball was inside.
But it just speaks to the toughness of Dijak.
Joe Gacy!
What on earth?
What did we just see? But wait a minute, back to live action. Dragunov didn't see what happened, nor did the official. But there's a big H-bomb delivered right in the center of the ring for the NXT champion.
Here is your winner, the NXT champion, Ilja Dragunov.
Well, Dijak's brand of justice not served up tonight. And somehow, some way, give credit, take your hats off to both these superstars. Because for Dijak, there was a few occasions in this matchup we thought he was close to pinning the NXT champion, springboarding from the top, but damaging that already injured elbow from this past Sunday when he faced that superstar, Joe Gacy, in a no disqualification match. The official didn't see it, Dragunov didn't see it, but bam! That vicious H-bomb connected between the nose of Dijak, and the NXT champion reigns supreme. Once again, long legs! Just like he did to Trick. Anything, it's when Hayes shoots, he don't miss.
Here in my face, and I'm obviously going to break them. I never run from challenges. I handle them in face.